The 98 Women of Water Sports Tour began near the city by the bay on famous Lake Chabot in Vallejo. Team Malibu drew first blood with four-time world champ Andrea Gaetan taking the wakeboard title. On the slalom course, teammate Jill Knutson could not be topped, running 1.5 buoys at 38 off. Team Nautiques pulled their wild card in tricks, and it paid off with Ronnie Barton acing the trick event. On the ramp, Team Overton's Tony Neville bested the field, jumping 145 feet. Though fellow Aussie Emma Shears tried to crash her party. Team Malibu opens the season with the title and the bragging rights. Today, WOW skis into Minneapolis to take on the mighty Mississippi next. From the beautiful towering skyline of the Twin Cities, Minneapolis-St. Paul, it's the Lifetime Fitness Center's Water Sports Challenge at the 59th Aquatennial Festival. Hi, I'm Camille Duvall, and the women of water sports take to the mighty Mississippi in picturesque Minneapolis. We're here in Minnesota, the birthplace of water skiing. My partner for this weekend is Simon Hill, four-time Australian national slalom champion. And we have a unique format this weekend, right?
Yeah, we do, Camille. On the WOW Tour, we have a unique format. It's a team format where we have five athletes in four different teams. Now, four of those athletes are dedicated to the specific disciplines and one wild card. They'll be slaloming through the course, trick skiing, which is the gymnastics on water, the spectacular long-distance jumping, and then what we call the snowboarding on water, the wakeboarding. And athletes to look for this weekend will be the winner in the tour stop back in Vallejo, Jill Knutson.
Ton Han, world record holder and world champion in trick skiing.
Tony Neville, former World Cup champion. She is a very experienced athlete on the jump skis.
And in wakeboarding, look for a battle royale. Andrea Gaetan, 98 X Games champion, takes on 15-year-old world champion Tara Hamilton. And now for a little insight, let's go down to the dock to Sonia Scheffler.
Camille, today wakeboarding is going to be the battle of the best. But one thing every athlete's going to have to contend with is the Mississippi River's current. It's going to make it harder on skiers and tougher on boat drivers to maintain a constant speed. But regardless, today is going to be an incredible event.
Incredible event and incredible Team Malibu, last week's champion, with Andrea Gaetan, 98 X Games champion, and Ton Han pulling in the tricks.
And Team Nautiques, our defending jump champion there, Tony Neville, and 1998 Masters champion, Brandy Hunt in there.
And Team Overton's Gretchen Hammerberg in wakeboarding, Christy Overton very strong in slalom.
And Team Mastercraft, Jennifer Leachman, April Coble, and keep an eye on Tara Hamilton.
Today's WOW venue, the mighty Mississippi. Skiers are dealing with currents and some wind whipped up by a nearby storm. Rough, rough water. But here's your scoring. First place in the event, 4 points. Second, three. Third place, two, and so on.
Yeah, but the real trick there, Camille, is trying to get the pass score, and the score's there listed for you. If any skier attains that score, they will get bonus points for the team. Jill Knutson warming up for the slalom event, and it's going to be tough, tough going out there. The rules are fairly simple. It's a four-buoy course. Boat speed is set at 34 mile an hour. Four passes, but unlikely to make four passes in the water out there at the moment.
Yes, that's going to be a challenge. And here is our first challenger, Jill Knutson, skiing for Team Malibu. Now remember, she is last week's champion from Marine World in Vallejo, California. But look at this water, Simon.
Okay, this is 22 off, and it's absolutely atrocious out there. To turn a ski in that water is unbelievably difficult. All right, she's sunk the tip of the ski already, past number one, and her day is over.
She can't even believe it. She's hiding her eyes. She seems to be okay, though. Didn't hurt herself. Let's take another look.
Well, she's just turned around bowl two there. See, the tip of the ski is just drilled straight into the front of a wave, and out she went.
But still a pretty smile coming up on the dock. There's Team Malibu, her teammates, going, it's okay, the water is really rough. But next on deck, we have Susie Graham. Now, she is the tough Canadian skier, and she's used to these kind of conditions. I think she's got a pretty good chance of making that first pass, Simon.
Yeah, she is a very, very gritty, determined skier. Now, we can see she's already made her first pass of 22 off. This is now 28 feet. Now, that's 28 feet off of your standard 75-foot rope. You see her here around bowl three, absolutely doing really well, Camille, and the conditions, experience paying off there.
It looks pretty bumpy out there. The ski is moving around a lot, but she's skiing steadily and looks like a little bit carefully too. Take another look right here around number one.
Yeah, you can see the water there, just unbelievably rolly. The ski, watch the tip of the ski chattering there as she comes into the bowl and out the exit there. She's coming in now at the next pass. This is 32 feet, and she's gone in completely inside the bowl. The conditions look atrocious from that end, Camille.
Skiing with the current seems to be tough. Let's go to Sonia on the dock.
Jill, the wind conditions and the rollers in the water, is that kind of making it tough on you girls?
It's real tough in the start of the course. And it's just real rolly out there, and conditions were as bad as I've seen.
Well, she can still laugh about it, but I don't know if Christy's laughing about it. She's got to go out and ski in those conditions. This is Christy Overton, captain of Team Overton.
Yeah, and she, again, is an experienced campaigner, the same as Susie Graham. Let's have a look now. She has, interestingly enough for you, Camille, elected to start at 28 off. Now, that's a pass shorter than the other girls, and she's in a lot of trouble here. A long way down course at four. Can she get around? Just squeaks around four. Unbelievable stuff. Now, she is set up in a different situation. She's now coming in at 32 off at what looks like the better end of the court.
There's Jennifer Leishman preparing for her run from Team Mastercraft.
Okay, Overton's now 32 off for Christy, and she is in a lot of trouble there at ball one. She's going to have a tough time getting far down this course, and there she goes in at ball two. Looks like maybe one and a half.
Looks like her problems start right at the beginning of the course there. A lot of slack line. Got on her angle pretty well, but didn't change edges quickly enough coming into two. A lot of slack line. Ski over the rope. Down she went. There she is, her teammates. Not too happy with that run, but there's not a lot you can do. Not fun on the water, but fun here at the Lifetime Fitness Center's Water Sports Challenge. Today's event is being brought to you by Mastercraft, the leader in pulling farther ahead. By Inmar, inboard power technology for the long run. By Speedo, the only performance swimwear. By Revo, see what others don't. By Masterline, protested by skiers for skiers. By Bliss, cool stuff for girls. By Waterski Magazine, the world's leading water skiing magazine. And by Lifetime Fitness Centers, we fit your life. The women of water sports skiing on the mighty Mississippi against the beautiful backdrop of Minneapolis at the Lifetime Fitness Center's Water Sports Challenge. Next up, we have Team Mastercraft's Jennifer Leishman. Now, she'll be the last skier in the event, barring any wildcard skier, Simon.
Yeah, and she's going to have her work cut out there. The condition's still extremely bad. However, Jennifer, a very experienced campaigner also, and always skis particularly well in the rough water. Now, she also has started at 28 feet off, the same as Christy Overton. But just have a look at the water here.
The conditions really have changed. She doesn't have the ski chatter that the other girls seem to have.
Yeah, rather her than me, though. I'm glad I'm up here dry. Makes that first pass comfortably, and actually look pretty good there.
Team seems happy with that performance. They're smiling. They're probably smiling at the wind conditions dropping as well. Let's take another look here.
Okay, this is the replay around ball two to three. Look very, very aggressive through the wakes. Hooks that turn up there at three and can tell she's home from there. Now crunch time. She has to get around two and back to the wakes to take the event. Oh, a lot of slack line there. It's going to be hard to win. She's around two. She looks like she might even make three. Just gets around ball three. And wow, she's taken out the event. Sensational stuff.
That's a great run. Her team is very happy. Looks like it's going to put them in the lead, again, barring any wild cards. There we have 2.25 buoys, 2 1/4, at 32 off for Jennifer Leishman. Now, it looks like Team Malibu has decided to pull out their wild card.
Yeah, well, Laurie Kruger has been pulled out there for Malibu. They were totally dissatisfied with their performance. If you remember, Jill Knudsen only got a ball and a half. She also is starting at 22 off now. I'm not sure that's such a great idea, Camille. She has to get a long way through 32 off to even take a challenge. And oh, she's all out of control here.
Real
can
trouble.
She get to ball four? My goodness gracious, I don't know how she made it through that. Neither can she.
Neither can she. Look at her face. She looks totally surprised to be actually skiing out the gate. Look how strong she is coming through the wakes, riding all the way on the back of that ski. It's a good thing she's wearing some wetsuit pants, I think, Simon.
Yeah, now this is 22 off, so she still has to run 28 off before she can take a challenge at the win. So I'm not sure if the tactics here are going to work for her.
Let's bad number one.
She's in trouble here. Around two, a little stretched out at three. Oh, she's getting out of control here through the wakes. Oh, my God. She has gone slamming down there. Oh, and she looks a little stunned.
She looks hurt. She looks hurt.
By jingoes, an absolute pearler there. Let's have a look at this. A round ball three. Look at the handle. Gets away from her here at the wake. Trips over the wake, actually. And just slam dunk. Holy cow.
Look how far her ski went all the way out of the picture. Amazing. Ski all the way up towards, leaning down, dropping her head. Oh.
Well, she actually came into this event carrying an injury, and I'm sure that didn't do it much good.
Back hurt, your neck.
My neck. I just lost my wind for a long time.
Well, the judges are going to score her at 3 buoys at 28 off, even though she sacrificed her body in that run. So it looks like Jennifer Leachman is going to be your champion with 4 points. Let's go down to the dock with Sonia and Jennifer.
Jen, you are wow. You are women in water sports. You put this whole event together. You've been here since Wednesday. You go out there, somehow clear your mind, and you win. I mean, what does that take?
Actually, you know what? Actually, I think it helps me because I don't have time to think about my skiing. I'm busy thinking about executing the event and getting everything off and having the spectators enjoy the show. And I think that it tends to help me. I've won more WOW tournaments than I've won any other tournament, so I think it helps.
A day in the life of a pro skier is a busy one, as I can attest to. So here's your chance to experience a day in the life of bird lover Susie Graham.
That is one busy day. Did you ever imagine, before you were thinking about having kids, what it would be like afterwards and still skiing?
Oh, I never imagined it, that's for sure. It's definitely a lot busier pace than I ever expected, and some days I don't know how I fit it all in.
Because you have so many distractions and so much stuff going on at home, is it easier to concentrate at a tournament when you don't have your family around? Does it feel like sort of a vacation?
Well, I've never had that happen because they've always gone with me. I haven't ever gone to a tournament yet without Ricky and Cole. And I can't imagine doing it. It would be more of a distraction to me not to have them there, you know, worrying about them. And I just really love having them around. And I guess it's because now I'm a mother first and a skier second.
And a wife, too. She gets a little help from her husband, Rick McCormick, Hall of Famer and Olympic gold medalist. But next, we have coming up tricks on WOW on Tour. Welcome back to the Women of Water Sport here in Minneapolis. After the slalom event, Mastercraft's in the lead with 4 points. And we got the trick event coming up next.
All right, we're moving into the tricks. And Karen Trulove getting ready there for Team Mastercraft. She was the first skier off. Rules fairly simple. 2 20-second passes. You're only allowed to do any given trick one time. 3 judges and the highest total score win.
2 passes up and down this wind. Karen Trulove taking note of what's going on there, jumping off behind the Mastercraft boat with Team Mastercraft. And she is the 1997 National Women's Slalom Champion, but we're going to be seeing her trick ski today, Simon.
Yeah, and she's certainly no slouch on the trick ski. And in fact, Camille, I think what we'll find here is that the trickers will be affected the least by these conditions.
I think that might be right. It also looks like they have chosen to, or Karen at least, has chosen to come in with her hand pass going down current and into the headwind. So that means she's going to have her toe pass set up second, but she looks like she's moving pretty easily through this and should score well on this run, but it was close to the end of her pass that fall, Simon.
Yeah, well, she was moving through that fairly comfortably. Of course, her handle pass, which is fairly obvious, but into the just the 5 back, and just sank the tail of the ski there. It was a little disappointing, but she probably fell with only a couple of seconds up her sleeve.
Well, there's the team. They're conferring. Patty Zeisler, Jennifer Leachman, trying to decide how much she needs for her second pass, which is the toe run.
Okay, Ray Ponteau now. She starts with a very difficult toe, 540. And if you can see the rotations here, the names of these tricks are simply the amount of degrees they're turning. That was a 360, the wake 360 there. Very difficult here, and you can notice the foot's in the harness, so should she fall, she can't let go, so the rope is connected to the boat by means of a trick release.
Well, she looks pretty comfortable. She's sort of, well, our team likes that. She was looking a little puzzled toward the end. We'll have to see what the judges say for as far as the score goes. 5,010 points, that's a good score to start off the event for Team Mastercraft.
Yeah, great score there for Karen. I'm sure she'd be very excited with that. I think that actually close to a PB. Next on the water is going to be Starlet Smith.
Starlet Smith, the 1997 National Tricks Champion, and she has been tricking very well this year. She's also elected to start with her hand pass coming down current, starting with the Wake 5. They're moving into the series of the back-to-backs. Now, how does Starlet's performance stack up against Karen, Simon?
Well, it looks like she's tricking just a little bit slower, and some of the tricks are just slightly different in their degree of difficulty. Each trick is predetermined and has a point value dependent on how difficult the trick is. Now, it may appear that she's done a lot more tricks. However, the tricks weren't quite as difficult as the ones Karen's done, so perhaps probably not scoring quite as much.
Well, the 540-degree turn, the first trick in the run, a very important one, because if you fall, you're finished. So let's take a look at the toe run.
Well, the toe five there, that's the same opening trick as Karen Truelove, so it looks like she has a similar repertoire, but none of the tricks here are compulsory. They're all chosen by the skier, and you're trying to fit them in one after the other so you can do them as quickly as possible. Grabs the rope now for the toe wake-o and grab the back of the knee. They're trying to get a little extra pull. She's a little off balance here, trying to squeeze everything in 20 seconds and just about out of time here. And still going and gone.
Down she goes there on the end of her run, but her team is very happy. And with the trick she did, it looks like this may be one of her best runs she's had on the tour. Yes, 4,160 points. So good run for Starlet. Next up we have Brandi Hunt, and she is a hot skier to come out of Florida. She is the 1998 Masters overall champion, so she is the wild card and the trick skier, so she could have be skiing twice.
Okay, let's have a look at the hand pass. Again, she started there with a difficult 540-degree turn. A
lot of rough water there, Simon, too.
Leg going over the line there, and the conditions, again, still quite poor from the slalom event even. Foot out of the ski there. She's in a little drama there. Lost her place, but back in it now. Edges out for the flip. Hang on to your hats, folks. There's flip number one. And number two here. Looks like she's a little low. Rode it out, but didn't get much elevation there.
No, but teammates are counting up the scores there. Brandi not looking too happy. Maybe that little fanny dunk didn't feel so hot after her second flip. First one looks pretty good. She takes a nice strong edge into the second one. A little bit low, didn't have the height that she needed, just slid right off the second wake. Now coming in for her toe pass.
Okay, now she may start with the toe seven here. Watch for two full rotations.
One, two.
Great opening start. Oh, she's gone all up the side of that wake there, Camille, and slid out. And that's tragedy after a pretty good opening pass.
That is tragedy, especially for Team Nautique. They do need a good score considering their slalom run. So Brandy's going to be finished, and it looks like we have next on the water the defending world champion and world record holder, Tawn Pond.
Now, Tawn, of course, is a real gun in the trick. She has been actually at the top of this game for many, many years, a real pro. And how many times have we seen this trick run before, Camille?
Lots of different times, but you know, I noticed she's actually looking to do her toe run downwind, so maybe she has a different strategy than some of the other girls, Simon. Why would that be?
Interesting tactic, maybe trying to keep that breeze against her chest in the toe run, which is actually a little opposite to what they generally work on. However, a couple of the girls have fallen short, and maybe this is a different tactic. Maybe that's why she is a world champion.
Well, these tricks look like they have a high degree of difficulty in that run, and it shows with 4,020 points. So she nearly bested Starlet Smith's run with one pass.
With one pass. And have a look at the axis here, folks. Look at the line through the head, the hips, to the foot. Absolutely perfect all the way through this pass. She really is a talent on the trick ski. And let's check out the hand pass now. Again, the same opening trick as Brandi. But she's very, very clean here. Watch the tricks. Each trick is very precise. Look at that axis again.
And very quick.
Yeah, beautiful. Just like a gymnast out there, really racking off the scores. And she's going for 7,000 plus here.
Well, it doesn't seem that the conditions are bothering her at all. She is really moving nicely from trick to trick. There's the flip. Hey, and she throws the fist. She's pretty happy with that run, as is her team, Team Malibu.
Malibu, very happy with that. And we're going to look at the judges. 7,770, that's an awesome score for Team Malibu.
And more importantly, she gets the 2 bonus points. So we'll have to see if any of the teams can come up with that, but that's going to help shore up that bad slalom run Malibu had.
Okay, well, the door is open for wild cards when we come back.
Some people say I have great abs. You know what? It all came from water skiing. It's a great way to train your abs and your low back. Sure beats doing sit-ups.
The women of water sports take to the crazy conditions on the mighty Mississippi. Lifetime Fitness Center's Water Sports Challenge continues. Well, looks like Overton's has pulled out their wild card. Wild and crazy Regina Jaquez.
Yeah, very young skier, and she's Junior Masters Trick Champion in 97, and a fearless skier, being quite young. A little inexperienced under these conditions, but that may work to her advantage, Camille.
And starting with a very tough trick, that toe 7, same way that Tawn Hahn did. Do you think that's going to be to her advantage?
Well, I think it is, and if I came out after the world champion, I'd be sort of trying to imitate them as well. She's had a little trouble there.
Ooh.
The boat looks like the
great
wakes
save.
Are a little unbalanced over there, and she's just out of control, but managed to regain it. We've seen her do this before, Camille. Get out of control and then bring it back together, and she's still on the ski.
Little extra toe side slide outside the wake, but her team's happy. They're listening for the score on the radio. There we go, 32-60. So she is quickly overtaking her teammate score, Charlotte Smith. Look at this toe pass, strength and grace.
Yeah, and you have a look at this axis again we've been talking about, the head, the hips, and the foot all in a line. And now we come into the hand pass. Now she's trying to eclipse the score of Starlet Smith. If she can do that, then it was worth bringing out the wild card. And if she can eclipse 6,000 points, then they'll get those bonus 2 points, which is very important. She looks like she's in a good tempo here.
She's well on her way. Difficulty of tricks very high. She looks like she's also tricking very cleanly, which is important to the judges. Got to clear the wakes to get the point. She's moving fast on the end for a few little tricks. Throws the fist. I think she thinks she's done it, as does Team Overton's.
Christy there was listening in on the radio, and Regina there with a tremendous score, pulled out 6,010.
And most importantly, those bonus points,
absolutely.
Simon.
Absolutely. So that was a really good move by Team Overton.
Susie, as team captain of Nautique, you're sending Brandy back out to do the trick event again. So we're just wondering, what's the strategy on that?
Well, people might think it's a little bit strange that Brandy gets to go twice, but the problem was what happened is 2 days ago, Ronnie Barton, our fifth team member, was injured and had 2 layers of stitches put in her knee, and so she was unable to come at the last minute. So that's why Brandy had to go ahead and do the wild card position as well as the tricking.
Well, team captain's work is never done. One more job for a busy day. Here's Brandy. Right back on the water, but she's starting with her toe pass this time, Simon. Is there some strategy here?
Yeah, it looks like she's trying to, she's gone to school on the world champ, Tawn Hahn, that had that big score out there, and as I say that, she's on the heels. Now, this is tragedy here because she was trying to beat her own score of 2,300.
Ooh, Tony, chewing her fingernails, she is worried about that.
Well, she's trying to get more points, but now she's fallen, and she's really got pressure on here. I don't know if she can do it.
She's got to make every trick in this run count. Right, Simon?
Yeah, and it's going to be tough here. And she's done a leg under. Put a leg under the line instead of over, and she's, well, what a catastrophe.
Looks like a mental error on Brandy's part. Speaking of errors, Mastercraft is pulling out their wild card, April Coble. I wonder about that strategy, Simon. How does the wild card work?
Well, the wild card is basically a backup score. If one of your athletes has failed to do as well as you think they can do, you can bring out a wild card, and they're like a little insurance, but that chance is spent. And Mastercraft is spending theirs over the top of Karen Trulove, who's already tricked 5, so interesting.
April Coble, though, certainly capable of doing that. The Masters overall champion and a good all-around skier in all 3 events. Now, she's electing to start with her hand pass. What do you think, Simon?
Well, I think she's going to have a work cut out to actually top Karen Trulove. And as I say that, she's gone down. And so even with her second pass remaining, it's going to be tough for her to actually beat Karen's score. She might as well swim in from there.
Yeah, she might. Looked very good there on her first trick, but looked like she just kind of tipped the rope with her toe. Knocked her off balance and down she went.
Okay, well, it's going to be all or nothing here for April. It'll be impressive if she can score over 5,000 in this pass. But we'll have a look anyway. Rope on toe, and you can see here moving through that, actually looking quite comfortable here. Of course, a little pressure off now that she's fallen, and there's a little chance of achieving a great deal as far as team scoring. So she might as well just rip through there and gets a little stretched out, but recovers anyway.
She does, but I don't know. I really think she's going to have a tough time beating that score. Oh, and down she goes. She probably needed those last couple little tricks. to get up there over the 5,000 point run. And there's her teammates looking on. They can't decide either. They're
probably
sort of nervously waiting
like,
the scores.
Looking like that maybe wasn't a great idea. 3,180 for April. So Tawn Hahn at 7,770. Fabulous.
Tawn's run shaking up the leaderboard, moving Malibu from last into second. Regina Jaquez, great run, putting Overton's in first. And Mastercraft drops to third.
My strategy out there was just to go out there and ski strong because I was not going to let that wind beat me. So went out, had a good time. Actually got more height on one of my toe tricks than I think I've ever gotten, which was a lot of fun.
A lot of fun for the trick skiers maybe, but not for the jumpers. Patty Zeisler of Team Mastercraft battening down the hatches to battle the mighty Mississippi. Jumping up next.
Well, the river is work, but famous Lake Minnetonka means fun in the sun as the women of water sports discovered on their stay in Minnesota.
Water sports back in Minneapolis. Got a tight race going on today. Overton's in the lead. Malibu behind by 1 point. Mastercraft behind by one. And Nautique's got a little bit of work to do coming up in the jump event. Jumpers on the dock preparing, getting ready, getting the bindings wet, using a little soap. Time and the rules.
Yeah, well, it's fairly simple. We have three attempts at the jump round. They're going to need all of those. The ramp set at 5 foot. Boat speed 32 mile an hour. And just checking that out, it looks better suited to sailboards than water skis. But let's have a look at Patty Zeisler.
Patty Zeisler, former national champion in jumping, and unfortunately she's got to be a guinea pig in these very, very rough conditions. And you can see right here, look at the jump. It's actually close to the skier. It's tilted away from them. Let's see how Patty handles it.
Okay, just a single cut here, trying to take a look at the conditions, which is a fairly tender start, and actually climbs up on the toes there to have a bit of a look. At 78 feet, the best there, Camille. A bit of a guinea pig, Patty.
Yeah, she was. There's Sherry Sloan strapping on her knee braces with some extra tape. She's going to need it in those conditions. And I bet if I was a skier, I'd be down there drawing straws to see who had to go first. Not something I'd want to do. Next on deck, we have Susie Lohr. Now, she is, she could actually pull something out of the hat here.
Yeah, well, again, one of the younger skiers on tour, a real go-getter. Now, she's on the opposite side of the wake. She's going to take a better run-up, so what we call a three-quarter cut. Again, you can see that ramp is not parallel to the course, but nonetheless,
oh,
Susie's
look at
having
those
a
rollers
cut.
At the bottom of the ramp.
Now, that she did not hold it back at all. And let's have a look here. Just after the wakes, between the wakes and the ramp, the most important part of the cut, right here. Boom, boom, boom. Just some unbelievably bad water there, but just kicked it anyway.
Well, nice to get a score under the board after passing on her first jump. Let's take a look on the third and see what she can come up with.
Okay, a little bit more anxious on the cut here, a lot more speed, and that looked like a better jump and a pretty courageous performance. You wouldn't catch me out there.
Simon, you're a slalom skier, that's why. Next up, we have Sherry Sloan. Now, she's recovering from an injury, feeling a bit apprehensive. She's up next when we return. The women of water sports are back. We've got Sherry Sloan on the water. Third out in the jumping event for Malibu. What's going through her mind right now, Simon?
She'd be extremely nervous, I'd say. Sherry has had reconstructions on both knees. Conditions like this are very, very dangerous. So she's going to be pretty apprehensive on this first one. God, the water is absolutely atrocious. And she is just trying to survive out there. Managed to ski away 93 feet. And incidentally, 94 is the distance to beat from Susie Lohr.
Well, she's going to have to put it together a little bit more. Take a look at that first jump. Skis slapping, a little bit of crush on the jump. Arm out for balance, but she skied away and survived the jump, as you noted, which is really important for Sherry. Now let's see what changes she makes for her second attempt.
Okay, she's a little bit later this time. Hopefully she can maintain a better edge to the base. The water looks slightly better that time. Got good lift, and that was a much better jump. It looks like she got a kick up the backside.
Yep, about 100 feet worth of pick up the backside, which is what she needed right over that 94-foot mark to take Team Malibu into the lead, but she's got to hang on. That's a tough landing out there, Simon.
Okay, well, narrowly skied away, 100-foot jump in the lead. She's going to try and top that now. She has Tony Neville coming up behind her, and again, the conditions there were just atrocious at the base and looked like about the same spot.
Well, that rough water, 101-foot jump, that's a great jump, and I tell you, fighting it all the way. But we have a fighter coming up next. That's Tony Neville. She is capable of jumping out in the 140-foot range, Simon.
Absolutely, and former World Cup champion. She is a very experienced athlete on the jump skis. Now, interestingly enough, Kim, it looked like on the middle jump of Sherry's, the water was the best. So let's have a look, see what it looks like on the first one there. Same as Sherry, extremely bad conditions. And, whoa, nearly going out the front. Looks like a really tough time trying to ride those jumps out.
Well, 99-foot effort, so right there close to Sherry Sloan, your leader, 101 feet. Nautique has got to put something together, but Tony looks very aggressive. Look how wide she is on her second attempt, generating lots of speed, skis knifing through that rough water coming to the bottom. Excellent kick way out over the front of the skis. I don't know, Simon.
Well, that was, oh, there it is right there, 112 feet, fantastic. That's exactly what Nautique needed. Now, the pass score is incidentally about 30 feet beyond that, so I don't think the bonus points are going to play here. But again, the same as Sherry's, the conditions were best for the middle jump, which is interesting. But a great-looking jump there by Tony Neville. And now one more to see if she can try and eclipse par scoring, which is around 130 feet. Not much chance of that, I wouldn't imagine, in this condition.
But definitely waiting letter, coming right on the edge of the jump, carrying a little more speed, but maybe not quite the lift, 111. So right in that same area. You can see how close to the bottom corner she is coming on the ramp. Ski's splitting a little bit, but nice form in the air and a really pretty landing in those conditions. I think she'll be happy just to have survived that run, Simon.
Absolutely.
Congratulations to the winner, Tony Neville. It's a horse race. Overton's in Malibu, tied with 10. Mastercraft and Nautique with 7. Bonus points, chance pass by for Tony Neville. Let's go to the doc for her perspective.
The only thing I was disappointed for is after the second jump, I really thought I could hit the 130 because I was just so early on all of them, but the jump was really close, so my perspective was different to what I'm used to. But it wasn't as bad. I guess I expected it to be worse than it was.
One event to go, wakeboarding. These two girls are going to take it to the limit. Go big or go home when we come back.
Your MR engine is an awesome machine. In order to keep it running smoothly, check your hour gauge. When it gets to 50, change that oil.
Welcome back to the Lifetime Fitness Center's Water Sports Challenge. This is anybody's competition. Overton's in Malibu tied, Mastercraft and Nautique tied, going into the final event, wakeboarding. It's going to tell the tale, Simon. How about the rules?
Okay, well, the aerial stunts, expression session format, two passes or three falls, one double up, and the most amount of points wins, but more importantly, Camille, variable par scoring or bonus points for this event.
Variable par score is any inverted tricks over 4 equals a bonus point.
Okay, well, Gretchen Hammerberg for Team Overton's will be one of the first out there, one of the young up-and-comers, and again, the conditions have maintained their poor status throughout this whole event. But again, against the jumpers and the slalomers, I don't think it's going to affect the wakeboarders as much.
Well, they also look like they're able to ski in a little bit closer to the shore, and the water may be a little calmer, although it didn't look like it for Gretchen's trick there. What have we got, Simon?
Okay, well, she opened up with the tantrum, which was a pretty nice-looking trick. Yeah, that's a clean tantrum, about as clean as you can do it there, but just lost her place a little bit on one of the rollers, and that was the end of her first pass. So pass number 2 now coming up, and it looks like she's coming in backside, backside front roll, and lands that one cleanly. And probably needs to hurry up, seeing she fell off, trying to get a few more tricks in here, and over-rotating big time on that, and looks like she went straight to the bottom of the lake on that.
That was a pretty tough fall she had. Now, each of the skiers are not able to do the same tricks over again, or they don't count for the score, so everything has to be different.
Exactly. It cannot repeat, and each trick is done individually to try and count up the inverts. Remember, anything over 4 will get bonus points, and it's very important for the two teams lagging to try and get bonus points. So let's have a look at the double up. This is where the two wakes meet together and didn't quite put it together, only getting a wake jump in there. But ordinarily, where the boat crosses its own wake from the turnaround, there's a mountain of water there for some huge, huge air. But the opportunity missed by Gretchen Hammerberg.
Well, Gretchen having a tough run all the way around, only scored 2 inverts. The intensity was there. The judges knew she was trying hard. She got 25 points, but was unable to pull out the bonus. That's going to hurt Overton's in the team race.
Yeah, now I said that the conditions probably wouldn't affect these girls, and I actually take that back after seeing Gretchen go all the way down and back. The water there is really breaking the wake up. It looks like it's very difficult to try and pick out where the top of the wake is, which is all important to get the big air.
Next on the water, we have Jamie Nekrasen for Team Nautiques. Now, her team is tied for third. She needs to pull out a big run to move into the lead. Most importantly, she's got to go to school and get those bonus points on the inverts, more than four.
Okay, pass number one for Jamie Nekrasen. Team Nautiques just warming up there, getting a look at the wakes. Remember, these girls have not ridden today behind this boat, so she's just doing a couple of grabs. There's another grab there, just feeling out the wakes. Okay, I reckon I've got it figured out now. Let's go for it here. Hillside pulls off a back roll cleanly.
Very intense, too.
Looking good. Okay, she's stayed the same way, so she's front side now, toes to the wake, and the toe side back roll landed beautifully on the downside of that wake there. And coming in backside to revert. So a very good high-scoring pass for Jamie on pass number one.
So we're looking at three inverts for the first pass. There's her team. They're pretty happy with that. They're well on the way to the bonus points. Let's take another look.
Okay, we'll pull that off cleanly. See, lovely landing on the backside of the wake there, the little down ramp, if you like. Okay, pass number two now comes in toe side or front side, same thing. The scarecrow pulls that off, and again, clean landing.
Trick.
Yeah, she is really pulling off some crisp stuff here. A little indie grab there.
It looks and like she's moving very quickly.
Very close to the shore there, and switches that one around. She's really throwing the score out here, going for it big time. A little more sense of urgency now, trying to hurry up. Probably realizing that she needs a couple of more inverts, and there we go.
Oh,
and she's failed to ski that one out there.
Well, it looks like she's got the four inverts. There's her team. They're all talking and counting. There she is. She's counting on her fingers. She needs one more to get five to get those bonus points. Okay.
So pressure here. This is intense stuff. She's got to get one more invert in before her pass is over. Comes in there for the backside roll, but just looked like she over-rotated a little bit, landed on the tail of the board, and so she has to quickly try and fit this in again.
Before the double up.
Before she turns around, and she does, so the boat is right at the bridge now, has quickly swung around and brings in for the double up. And, oh, it's a pretty big attempt at a tantrum there, but again, I said that I didn't think it was actually that rough. You could see it was almost impossible to pick out that double.
Swimming around the soup, Jamie Nekrasen with a great run. 60 points and two bonus points. Nautique's got to be happy, but there's the woman to beat, Andrea Gaetan, 1998 X Games champion. Up next.
Meanwhile, let's join the girls for a little more summer fun at Lake Minnetonka.
Lifetime Fitness Center's Water Sports Challenge. Up next, Andrea Gaetan for Team Malibu. She has got a little bit of work to do, son.
Absolutely, Camille, and it's not going to be easy out there. We've seen the girls struggling with the conditions that we had all day, and it's no different for these girls. Andrea Gaetan, their four-time world champion, and she is definitely an experienced campaigner when it comes to riding this board. So we'll have a look and see how she starts here.
Coming in for her first pass there, starting off with a big trick right away.
Yeah, right away. Big back roll there, coming in front side now. Front side back roll, and aggressive start here from Andrea.
She really knows she needs to work. She is trying to get those inverted tricks in. And look, a helicopter. Now, that doesn't count as an inverted trick, but it is high style in the judges' books.
Exactly. Coming in now, a little switches around, roll to revert, and switch again. So she's really packing him in here.
Yeah.
Great stuff.
Changing positions, moving around, big air and big intensity. That's what the judges like.
They're going the big tantrum. Now, she's nailed every trick so far, and she's got to be feeling good about this. coming in now, toe side. Swings around for the reverse 360, but dropped the handle and may have almost been a fake drop there, going for a little bit of a rest after that huge performance.
Let's take another look. She had a solid run. She's looking at four inverts, so she's got one more to go to get into that bonus points territory, Simon.
Yeah, and the thing that's really exciting is the girls have gotten a lot bigger in the last couple of years. Again, they're a huge opening trick. Managed to fall off, unfortunately, but they're going a lot higher than they were last year, Camille.
Well, I think that intensity counts. They like that on the judges' part, and it's important to score when it comes down to brass tacks. The beautiful skyline of Minneapolis. Let's certainly
makes a great backdrop here, and now we're going to see some more of that here if we can get Andrea up in that skyline somewhere. And a good looking roll there. So she needs another couple of inverts still, and she's thrown in a grab there, still needs to pack in some more inverts. Come on, Andrea, time is running out. There we go. Throws in the front row, and she's fallen again. Now, she came out of the box with a huge run here. A couple of extra inverts she's needed, she's failed to ski away on. That's going to hurt him.
Looks like she had plenty of air on this one, came around and just caught the tip of her board. That's a pretty tough fall.
Drilled the tip of that thing.
Now, because she fell twice, she's not going to get her double up, so she's going to have to settle for 50 points and two bonus points.
Okay, well, next out on the water will be Tara Hamilton, the young gun. In 1996, was Rookie of the Year, and in 97, World Champ and Tour Champ. A little earlier today, Camille had a chance to catch up with Tara Hamilton.
Fame and fortune. At 15, you became the world champion. How did that change your life?
I had to start traveling a lot and just all that stuff. And then I'm really happy now because I turned 16. I have my car, so it's a little easier. I can drive myself out to the lake every day and all that.
Now, you're training with Darren Shapiro, and he's one of the premier names in wakeboarding. Do you think his style's rubbing off on you a little bit?
Yeah, definitely it's had to, because I've learned everything from him. I've been training with him since the beginning, so his style has definitely rubbed off on me a little bit.
Now, you won your world championship at 15. You've got to defend it at 16. What do you think your chances are this year?
They seem pretty good. I've been training real hard all season, and hopefully, as long as I stand up, I'll have a pretty good chance.
Now, what do you think about the WOW Tour format as far as team competition? Do you like it?
Yeah, this is my first one, and it seems like a lot of fun, and all the teams are really stoked on each other and everything. It seems really fun.
Well, good luck this year.
Thank you.
Stoked she is. She's coming out for Team Mastercraft, and she has a big chance here to pull her team into the lead, Simon.
Yeah, absolutely. If we can get, I think she did like 8 inverts out of Tara, and that can bring her team up into the win. But there's a lot of pressure there for such a young girl.
So she's looking at 4 inverts in each direction, plus on the double up. So she's starting off big with a tantrum.
Yeah, and the one thing that's exciting to watch about Tara, she definitely goes biggest of all the girls out there, pulling out the front side back roll, and she's holding nothing back.
She is going for it from stem to stern. Look at these tricks. Big air, high intensity, and one right after the other. Action packed.
Yeah, big roll to revert, to switch there. And yeah, one after the other, and they are big. You may notice how high she's going in comparison to a couple of the other girls. She goes for 360 there, trying to get back across the wakes.
Little stall points and set up. There's her team. They're kind of counting up, and I think she's going to end up with 4 inverts on that first pass. Let's take another look.
Okay, well, coming in there, as you can see there, a lot of composure and big air, which, of course, as she mentioned, her coach Darren Shapiro is famous for that big, big air form.
Beautiful tricks. Wow. Roll to revert. Awesome.
Okay, let's have a look now at pass number 2. Coming in now on the backside, and it's a massive air rally right over the city of Minneapolis.
That is beautiful, and actually that is her coach, Darren Shapiro's signature move.
Absolutely, goes there for a little front roll, and it looks like she had a little trouble riding that out. Didn't quite get around onto her toes. Difficult trick to ride out, however.
Well, she knows she's got to put together a nice run here at the end. Let's take another look at this air rally. This is spectacular. Now, this does count as an inverted trick because the board is over her head, even though she's not actually doing a roll.
Totally inverted. You see, coming in the awkward side here, toe side, going with that toe side front roll, and just failing to get all the way up onto the board to ride away.
Looked like she had a bad position from the start, so she has to go right in for the double up.
Okay, double up here, throws the tantrum, an absolute picture book stuff there.
Well, Team Mastercraft Captain Jennifer Leachman looks pretty happy. Let's see what the judges score. 65 points and 3 bonus points. That's enough for the outright win, but this presents a pretty interesting scenario as far as the team score goes, Simon.
Well, it's going to be difficult to try and add this up and see how those bonus points affect the team fairings. So, well, we're going to have to wait and see on that one.
Well, while we're waiting, let's go shopping. Where else?
The Mall of America. Let's go, girl.
Their feet are tired and their wallets are empty. But the winners of this competition, Malibu and Mastercraft, in a first ever tie, their wallets are full. Nautique and Overton's pulling in third and fourth respectively. It was a great event out in these very trying and rough conditions, but the teams all made it through unscathed, maybe with the exception of Lori Kruger. But we'll be right back with the rest of the women of water sports. The Lifetime Fitness Center Water Sports Challenge was brought to you by Mastercraft, Inmar, Speedo, Revo, Masterline, Bliss, Waterski Magazine, and Lifetime Fitness Centers. And on the tour, after two stops, Malibu in a solid lock with 7.5 points, Mastercraft following up with 4.5. Geared up, the Waterski companies. Kind of a mix-up at the top there. O'Brien, 9. Conley, 7.5. KD with 6. Wakeboard Company's Full Tilt right in there with 10. Hyperlite with 8. And Geared Up Wetsuits. Overton's with a big lead, 21.5. Jet Pilot in second with 13. Hope you enjoyed this air rally and all the other fantastic skiing this week on the Women of Water Sports.